Welcome to our very first episode of The Tea on Recruiting, where we share insightful and thought-provoking content that can help you shape your career. Why did we call it The Tea on Recruiting? Well, that's simple. The show is for recruiters like you, and I am obsessed with tea. Like, seriously, I can't stop. We're also going to be spilling some tea for sure at the end of these episodes. Watch Netflix? We know you do. So a show came out called Ratched, and Netflix has a video of the cast reading out guidelines on hiring women from this 1940s manual. And they're barbaric. I mean...
This is a guide to hiring women. What do you make of that, you guys? When you have to use older women... By the way, that phrase, when you have to use older women...
Okay, I think we've heard enough. I am pretty sure that this is not the way that you hire women in 2020. But there are plenty of minorities out there, and whereas we have certainly improved in candidate treatment over time, sadly some businesses are still quite backward, and it might be that yours is due and you don't even know it. Imagine if the cast of Ratched had this conversation about your recruitment process. It would be humiliating, wouldn't it? How does your Glassdoor page look like? The reviews on it might not be from Sarah Paulson, but they're definitely out there for the world to read.
Don't be sorry. Be better.
So before we start, let me give you a fundamental piece of advice. Measure your candidate experience. You cannot fix what you don't know. Asking the right questions to your candidates through a respondent-friendly feedback tool, and then analyzing this data and deriving insight can actually make a difference in your career. And on to the second piece of content that we're gonna share with you today. The article Why You Need a Social Media Recruiting Strategy and How to Make One is from December 2019, and yet it's never been as relevant as it is right now. The days we're living in are beyond bizarre.
Coronavirus! Coronavirus!
If social media was relevant before in order to show the world what your company culture is like, well, imagine the power of digital communication now that so many of us are working from home. You might say that you're slowing down your hiring process, but well, the applicants that you want are actually the top-notch type of talent that can turn things around when goes down. Why would you want top talent? Isn't it cheaper to hire average talent and then train them? Well, the answer is no. Netflix said that star performers are 2 times better than average at procedural work, and actually when it comes to creative and inventive work, they're fully 10 times better than average. McKinsey & Company estimated that high performers are 900% as productive as average performers in high complexity jobs. Okay, so you need a social media recruiting plan, but how do you create one? Well, we got you! There are 5 main steps. Step number 1, create your social media accounts. And by this I mean that you can have separate ones for jobs and careers. This way you're gonna be easier to find, and you can use these to showcase your culture, to build relationships with potential future talent, and more. Now, it's really important that you're gonna be creative both in terms of platforms and your approach to them. This way you can differentiate yourself in the market. Step number 2, learn how to leverage Boolean operators so that you can target specific audiences. Step number 3, post regularly.
Do it! Just do it!
Step number 4, expand into new networks and forums. If, for instance, you think that your candidates are going to be hanging out on Reddit, on Quora, on academia.eu, then this is where you're supposed to be. Point number 5. Get your employees motivated. They can really help you with your employer branding, and they can do so with a much needed human touch.
Candy Crush!
The more barbaric your treatment of candidates, the more demonic their reviews on your Glassdoor page. We explored the dark side of this review platform, and we came out with a really nasty review that we're gonna share with you today. So shout out to a famous company that I'm not gonna name. They had this anonymous candidate who somehow then ended up taking a job at that company, but well, let's hear what they shared. It was a seemingly endless amount of hoops to jump through. The interview had some very odd questions and verged on being discriminatory. By the time you've finished, you feel like you've joined a cult. And that's because you have. Take it all with a grain of salt. It's only a temporary job. Well, my friend, I really hope so. Got something to say about this? Drop a comment in the section below. We'd love to pick your brains. To get more news, subscribe to our newsletter. You're gonna find it linked below or at start.com/newsletter. Thank you for watching the TM Recruiting. Take care and see you soon.